Yeah, we all know that crowdfunding can be a risky business, especially when you pay for the product without ever trying it, without even knowing if it'll become a reality or not. After all, some campaigners secretly don't know how to price their product, start production, or even ship to their backers, which completely sucks. So let's talk about some of the biggest mistakes in the Kickstarter world and how to avoid them. By the end of this video, you can fully indulge in crowdfunding, informed and carefree. Note, I won't mention obvious scams because when someone out there in the ether offers you, quote, 100% silver anti-radiation underwear with thermal connectivity for the low, low price of $30, I think we all know that's just too damn good to be true. Kickstarter failure number 10, the Montrex watch. We'll start with a complete banger of a Kickstarter failure. The Montrex watch was a promising campaign back in 2012 that ended horribly. And by horrible, I mean that the owner wrote an update that blamed the backers for the failure of the project. Why, yada. The backers saw that his updates were a bit weird at first, but they didn't suspect it would affect their product. But it did. Great campaigners can have spelling mistakes and an unprofessional tone. That doesn't really matter so much. What we should be paying attention to is the quality of the communication. How open is the creator? Are they transparent with their backers? Are they providing honest value to their community? The lesson learned, check the quality of the communication. Kickstarter failure number 9, the Dragonfly Future Phone. Now, after looking at all the specs of this massive Kickstarter failure, I had to really take a minute, sit down, and write my own summary of the product to fully understand just maybe what went wrong. I tried including all the features. Here's how it turned out. Quote, a double-screened, two-way, dual operating system, 360-degree twin tablet smartphone with a detachable docking station, social computing laptop with foldable singular part twistable keyboard, double LTE mobile connection, a slide-out touchpad, and stylus. Oh, and did I mention that all that tech fits in your slim jeans pocket, can extend fourfold, and has a double touchscreen for just $800? I have no idea what I just said. Confused a little? Yeah, what the fuck? The best is that this product wasn't really a joke at all. The creators actually believed they could do all of that at the promised price. And unfortunately, the 4,230 backers of the product did as well. The creator of the Dragonfly Future Phone campaign was found guilty in 2019 of 12 counts against him, including 6 counts of mail fraud and 6 counts of wire fraud, each punishable by a maximum sentence of 20 years in prison, and will be sentenced later this year. The lesson here is, if the product and price sounds too good to be true, it just might be. If they don't have a prototype, they may actually have no idea how to truly estimate the cost of their production. Kickstarter failure number 8, Triton. Have you always wanted to look like you were sucking on a bicycle handle while swimming? And also risk grave bodily harm or even death? Well then take a good hard look at the Triton. In contrast to the Dragonfly, Triton actually had a prototype. So what happened? They said their technology could extract oxygen from water so you can breathe. They called it artificial gill technology. Look, Ma, no oxygen, I'm a merman! But that all seems just so impossible for so many reasons. They didn't show that the product worked, they just said it did. Trust me, this comment talking about Triton's video explains the lesson perfectly. Lesson learned, it's in Kickstarter's terms of use that participants must have a working prototype. So demand that they do. On a related note, I'm thinking of creating a backer's guide video on what happens if a Kickstarter fails. Comment down below if you'd find this interesting or have any specific questions you'd like me to address. Kickstarter failure number 7, Zeno. Zeno was revolutionizing the world of drones back in 2016, and with over $3.2 million in funding, they were destined for success. But they only shipped around 5% of their drones, and many of them weren't even able to fly. What the fuck? I can't believe it. No, no! Insane Kickstarter failure. Escalating anger and disappointment. In an extremely in-depth 53-minute article, which I'll include in a link down below, Mark Harris, an investigative journalist which Kickstarter hired to evaluate why Zeno failed, noted, quote, Zeno had not only burned through the £2.5 million from its Kickstarter campaign, it had run up another £1 million in debt. Why? How is that even possible? The founder of Zeno had previously tried working with drones but failed many times in implementing the technology. However, he still kept trying and kind of, quote, fudging the truth about how functional or, quote, effective the tests were. Well, you have to admire the man's determination. He just never learned and lied about it. Lesson here is really look at the videos of the campaigns you want to back. In Zeno's, for example, we never saw their drone in a continuous shot to take off and fly. The product was never fully functional. Kickstarter failure number 6, the coolest of all coolers. It can open up your cold beers, charge your phone, be your best friend, and pour margaritas for your old friends from its 18-volt battery-powered blender. It could also grow 8 tomatoes, make a pizza from recycled underwear, and find your long-lost brother who you left in the Amazon rainforest at the age of 34 when your half-human, half-ogre parents decided to bring the family together. Okay, maybe the pizza part was a stretch, but the coolest cooler could do a lot of things. But the price, oh, the price. $185 for the features it contained was simply just way too low. So, did they fail to deliver? No. The product was successful. Tons of people are enjoying their coolest coolers right now, but on Amazon, and for a higher price. The backers from Kickstarter never got their pledge. Lesson to be learned here is that roughly calculate the price of each of the features in a product. If their product's price is lower than the collective features individually, well, consider that it might be impossible to produce. Of course, there are exceptions to every rule, and this lesson may not always be right. You need to also know that some campaigners are willing to produce something that is not profitable just to have a presence in the market and establish a brand. Kickstarter failure number 5, SCARP. SCARP was created by a group of guys who said they found the laser's frequency at which both light and dark hairs would melt. So they made a razor from it. They'd make a fortune off of my family alone. What they didn't say is that the laser frequency could only be transported through a very weak piece of string that would break if you touched it. Oh, also, if you looked at the string, you might get eye damage. Lesson learned. In my opinion, this is another case where a working prototype was required. They needed to have a prototype with at least, let's say, 80% readiness. SCARP had one bit of technology covered, but they needed so much more work to actually finish their product. This one is a super Kickstarter failure. But still, I'm looking forward to someone actually implementing laser razor technology at some point. Future, here I come. Kickstarter failure number 4, Znaps, or Znaps, or Schnapps anyone? This one is an example that's not so straightforward. It's when the technology works, but the campaigners suck. They made a great product, regularly updated the backers, had a great tone, and I believe they even had a good customer service. Until they kept delaying the shipping and eventually just disappeared, keeping their 70,122 backers waiting. Like a fart in the wind. They eventually started selling on Amazon, but the backers destroyed that plan. For all we know, they're probably selling the product under a different name on Amazon right now. Lesson here is that you must check that the campaigners put their names, pictures, and links on the campaign page, and their LinkedIn. If they don't have these, it's difficult to keep them accountable. Try to make sure, as much as you can, that they're real people. I've included a bonus link explaining how eventually Znaps or Schnapps or Znaps was tied to a Hong Kong crowdfunding scam circle. You can see the text down below. Kickstarter failure number 3, the AMA brush. The AMA brush seemed super legit. Maybe it didn't look sexy, but it seemed real at the very least. With almost $4 million in funding and even shipping some products, they would eventually file for bankruptcy, leaving thousands of backers disappointed. The reason for failure, they later said in a statement, was that no European manufacturers could produce the AMA brush at the price they quoted. It was a complex brush that needed automatic machining tools, which led to delays and unexpected costs. They settled for Asian manufacturers instead, but the product quality was low, and by then they had used up all of their money. Or your money. The creator had years of experience in business and apparently worked in Silicon Valley. Though he had an impressive CV, he didn't have the right skills. It seems as though he didn't have the right stuff to do business with his European and Asian manufacturers. Lesson here is that check if the creators have previous successful crowdfunding campaigns. If they have, and the new campaign is not so much more difficult or more technically challenging than their last, there's a good chance that they'll succeed. Kickstarter failure number 2, the Ouya, or the Ouya, or Ooha. How do I pronounce this? I have no idea. Okay, anyway. The Ouya console was a kick in the face to the world of gaming consoles. They wanted everyone to be able to develop and play games in an inexpensive way. And it seems that everyone else did too. The open source to Android game console raised a stunning $8.6 million. But when backers received it, all the components were garbage. Buttons would stick, controller connectivity sucked, and yet hardware was just one aspect of it all. The other was that the games sucked. As the console was open source and there were no good exclusive game development plans made, people just uploaded their unfinished projects to the Ouya and there was no quality control. The lesson here is that when a team starts a project at such a huge scale, their team should have the skill set equal to or even better than established competitors in their field. There wasn't a team section on the Kickstarter page, and the only real thing we heard from the creators was, quote, "I've been in the gaming industry for a long time," or "We've developed a lot of projects," and the two projects they developed before were nothing like the Ouya in production difficulty. Kickstarter failure number one. It's all good. What was the actual innovation being offered? Well, making a movie about not making a movie. I couldn't resist mentioning this golden oldie, a fake failed Kickstarter project. A comedy group asked their fans to help them finance their new movie. They received more than $76,000 from their backers. Then, nothing. They went silent. And some years later, they announced they won't be able to make the movie without any further explanation.
That was a success. We hit our goal and then some, which is why I'm so sorry to announce that the movie can no longer be completed.
Their fans were understandably enraged, especially since the trio seemed to post vacation and party pictures on Instagram in resorts and fancy places. What a sham! Backers felt betrayed.
Fuck, FND!
It's a bunch of bullshit!
Like, what did you even do with all that money?
Where the fuck is this film?
But then, in 2017, they uploaded a trailer for a movie about a comedy group that scams their fans for $70,000 on Kickstarter and then spends the money on parties and vacations. It was their master plan all along. Genius! What a joke. The backers, of course, received the movie for free and is now purchasable from their website. It's just an epic prank. Lesson here is have patience and good humor when backing campaigns. Kickstarter is not a shop, it is a place where you can support creators and possibly get something in return, if you're lucky. To sum things up, by learning some big Kickstarter failures and remembering these 10 lessons, you will be able to spot potential red flags in the future campaigns you'll want to back. Whether the prototypes seem fake, their product is priced too low, or their team isn't skilled enough, there's always going to be some inherent risk in crowdfunding. For me, that's also what makes crowdfunding thrilling. I back crowdfunding campaigns exactly because I help creators reach their dream and learn from their mistakes. Some of the best products I have are from crowdfunding, so don't lose your spirit. Go and buy fully informed with intention and skill.